Primary elections were held across the state this week. There were no statewide races this election, leading to relatively low voter turnout compared to 4 years ago, although the Secretary of State's office will not have official numbers for about another week. But hotly contested races did bring out more voters in certain counties. Gretchen Frazee takes a look at some of those key races and the major issues that affected the outcomes.
In your opinion, Indiana's proposed constitutional amendment banning same-sex marriage will not appear on the general election ballot this November, but it did seem to play a role in some of the primary elections. During a debate in the legislature earlier this year, Republican Representatives Rebecca Kubacki and Catherine Huwer voted against the amendment known as HJR 3. Both of them lost in their primaries against social conservative candidates who pledged to defend marriage between one man and one woman. Eric Turner authored HJR 3, but that didn't appear to affect his campaign. He won with 59% of the vote, even though he did receive some criticism for allegations that he violated House ethics rules when he lobbied against a nursing home construction moratorium, even though he and his son both have ties to the industry. Turner was cleared of those charges last month.
I believe I have 13 proponents.
Columbus Republican Representative Milo Smith was also a supporter of the marriage amendment, but his opponent, Bartholomew County Councilmember Ryan Lauer, did not make that an issue in the campaign. Instead, he largely focused on education issues. Smith won with 60% of the vote.
I feel relieved. This is the first time I've had someone from my own party challenge me, and I thought I was doing a good job, and apparently there were people that thought I could do a better job, so that's my commitment. I'm going to try to do a better job representing the people in my district.
Indiana voters renominated all their incumbents in the U.S. House of Representatives. All of those representatives won by wide margins. And Monroe County has been known as one of the counties with the slowest vote counts. But this week, it only took the county 3 hours after the polls closed to have all of its votes counted. Monroe County Clerk Linda Robbins attributes that to new electronic poll books.
Before e-poll books, the inspectors had to divide all the voted ballots by precinct, total them by precinct, and all the reports were done by precinct. Now we're able to do it by polling location, and it's just made their job much simpler.
This was the first year many counties in the state used e-poll books, and county officials reported few technical difficulties.
Many of the candidates who won in Tuesday's primary are uncontested going into the general election, but party leaders can still choose candidates to fill those spots before November, even if they didn't appear on the primary ballot.